Hello guys, today we are going to discuss numerical integrations. If you like my video, then press the like button and don't forget to subscribe it. Our first point is trapezoidal rule. The first we have to know what is the formula for trapezoidal rule. That is integration from a to b f of x with respect to x equals to h by 2 y naught plus y n plus 2 times y1 plus y2 plus up to y of n minus 1. As we know that f of x is a functional relation which is also denoted by letter y, therefore instead of that f of x we replace y in the formula, then the formula becomes integration from a to b, instead of f of x we write here y with respect to x equals to h by 2 in bracket y naught plus yn plus 2 times y1 plus y2 up to y of n minus 1. That is the formula of trapezoidal rule. Here x is the variable of that function f of x, or which is denoted by y. Here y naught is initial value of y, yn is the last value of y, and in that bracket all the remaining values of y, that is y1, y2 up to y of n minus 1. Basically in the example h is sometime given, otherwise we can find the h by this formula, h equals to b minus a divided by n, where a is a lower limit of the integration, b is the upper limit of the integration, n is the total number of intervals, and here h is the width of that interval. That is the basic information of trapezoidal rule. If we find y1, y2, y3 up to y of n, all these values of y and h, we can find the solution of the given function by using trapezoidal rule. For that, first we get an example. Let us see first example. Using trapezoidal rule, evaluate integration from minus 1 to 1, 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube with respect to x by taking n equals to 2. In that question, n is given, n is the total number of interval which is given, that 2. For solving this example, we have to know that the trapezoidal rule, integration from a to b f of x with respect to x equals to h by 2 into bracket y naught plus yn plus 2 times remaining all the values of y, that is y1, y2 up to second last term of y, that is y of n minus 1. Here we have to find all these value of y and h, which is not given in example. First we have to find h. In that question, what is given, that here 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube, it is a function which is denoted by f of x or y, that is equals to 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube. Here a is the lower limit of the integration, which is minus 1, and b is the upper limit of the integration, which is plus 1, and given that n equals to 2. First we have to find the value of h. By this formula, b equals to h equals to b minus a divided by n. Here given that b equals to 1, a equals to minus 1, and n equals to 2, substitute all these values in that formula, b equals to 1 minus a equals to minus 1 divided by 2. If you calculate this, we get the value of h, which is equals to 1. Then we have to find the all values of y. First we have find h, then we have to find all the values of y. Let us suppose that the value of x are given from minus 1 to 1, which is lower limit of the integration, that is 1, and which is upper limit of integration, that is 1. Therefore we have to find the values of y, that is y equals to f of x, which is given our question, y equals to f of x, that is 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube. First we put the value of x minus 1 in that equation, we get 1, value of x is minus 1 plus minus 1 square plus minus 1 cube, we get the value of y is 0. Therefore at the time of x equals to minus 1, the value of y is 0. Next, if we minus 1, if we add plus h, that is 1, we get the value of 0, that is next value of x. How to find next value of x? First value plus h equals to 0. Then if we put x equals to 0 in that relation, we get value of y, that is put x equals to 0, 1 plus 0 plus 0 square plus 0 cube, that is equals to 1. We write here, if you put x equals to 0, we get y equals to 1. Then again, next value of x, how to find? 0 plus h, that is 1, 0 plus 1, that is equals to 1. We write here, if you put x equals to 1 in that relation, we get y, 1 plus value of x is 1 plus 1 square plus 1 cube, that is equals to 4. Okay, that is clear how to find the values of x. That is, first minus 1 is the lower limit. If we add lower limit plus h, we get next value of x. If 0 plus 1 we add, then we get next value of y. If you put minus 1 in the relation, we get first value of y. If you put 0 in the relation, we get next value. If you put 1 in the relation, we will get next value. That is, value of y is 0, 1 and 4. That is initial value of y. Therefore, it is called as y naught. That is first value of y, that is called as y1. That is second value of y, that is called as y2. In the trapezoidal rule, we put all the values. That is integration from a to b. A means minus 1, b means 1. And function, which is given question over, 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube with respect to x, that is equals to h by 2. Y naught, that is first value of y, plus yn, that is last value of y, that is y2. We put here y2 plus 2 times remaining value, means only y1 is remains there, therefore put y1. Therefore we know that we have to find y naught, y2 and y1. Put all the values in the this formula. H equals to 1 divided by 2 as it is, plus y naught is 0, plus yn is 4, plus 2 times y1 is 1. After calculating these, we get the final value is 3. Therefore, integration from minus 1 to 1, 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube is 3. Okay, take again one more example of trapezoidal rule. Evaluate integration from 2 to 7, 1 upon x with respect to x by trapezoidal rule. Divide the interval 2 to 7 in 5 equal subintervals. Let us see what is the question and what are the given here. Y equals to f of x, that is 1 upon x, that is the function, which is question. That is, y equals to f of x equals to 1 upon x. Here a is the lower limit of the integration, that is 2, b is the upper limit of the integration, that is 7, and n equals to 5. Here given that n sub intervals, that is sub intervals are 5, that is n equals to 5. First we have to find h. The formula of h equals to b minus a divided by n. Here b is 7 minus a is 2. We put all the values b, a and n in the formula. We get the value of h is 1. Therefore, the interval between two class, this one, is 1. The difference between 2 and 3 is 1. Difference between 3 and 4 is 1. Difference between 4 and 5 is 1, and so on. Then first value of x is 2 and last value of x is 7. First value of x is 2 and last value of x is 7. Then we put the value of x in the given function y equals to f of x, we get the value of y. First put x equals to 2 in equation, we get y, value of y is 1 upon 2. Then next value of x, how to find x, the value of x plus h, that is 2 plus 1, 3, right here 3. Again we put this x in the functional relation, we get y equals to 1 upon 3 right here. Then 3 plus 1 equals to 4. Put this value in the relation y equals to fx equals to 1 upon x, that is 1 upon 4. We get 1 upon 4. Next 4 plus 1, 5. Put this equation, we get 1 upon 5. Next 5 plus 1, that is 6. Put this value in the relation, we get 1 upon 6. Then 6 plus 1, that is 7. Again put this in relation, we get 1 upon 7. That is a common thing. That is first value of y, y naught, y1, y2, y3, y4 and y5. That is initial value y naught, and that is last value, that is yn. By trapezoidal rule, that is the formula of trapezoidal rule as we earlier discussed. Therefore, integration a to b, that is lower limit is 2, upper limit is 7, 1 upon x with respect to x, that is our question. That is equals to h by 2 y naught, that is initial value of y, plus yn, that is last value, that means y5, put here, plus 2 times remaining all the values of y, that is y1, y2, y3 and y4. Since we have written y naught and yn already, therefore remaining values are these one, y1, y2, y3 and y4. After substituting these all the values, h equals to 1, y naught equals to 1 upon 2, y5 equals to 1 upon 7, plus 2 times y1 1 upon 3, y2 1 upon 4, y3 1 upon 5, and y4, that is 1 upon 6. After calculating all these values, we get the final answer 1.2715.